It is that exciting time again when you want to buy another bike, N plus one, right? But you're put off by the process, which is lengthy, never easy, plus the many options out there makes the final decision even harder. But in this video, you learn how to choose your road bike, the differences between them, and some tips so you can choose the best bike that will suit your need. I'm Daniel and welcome to The Cyclist, where we inspire you to become a better cyclist, amplify your knowledge, and of course, spread the word of cycling. If you're new here, make sure to click on that subscribe button and check out the links on the description of this video. So let's jump into it. Road bikes are the best choice for going fast and covering long distances because of their skinny tires, dropped handlebars, position and lightweight components. But within the classification of road bikes, there are lots of subtypes such as racing, climbing, endurance, and aero bikes. But on this video, you'll learn the differences between them and we'll only cover the drop handlebars. First, I'll cover some considerations you need to take into account before buying any bike, and then I'll explain the different types of bikes so you can choose the best one for you. Before we move to the type of road bikes, there are some important considerations you need to take into account when choosing the right bike, and they are usage, distance, fit, frame material, weight, and type of terrain. The first consideration is usage. You need to know what you're using the bike for. Is it to enter sportives? Is it to enter races? Is it to go off-road or to climb a hill faster? And yes, you can use the same bike to do all of those, but bear in mind that a bike built specifically for long sportives or to go off-road won't be the best choice for race or climbing hills fast. The second one is the distance. This is a very important factor. If you're aiming for long rides or sportives, you should choose a more comfortable bike since you'll be riding for hours. But if you're aiming for short but intensive rides, like a time trial, for example, you should aim for something fast, more aerodynamic, and you can get away with not being too comfortable since you won't be riding it for hours at a time. Another consideration is the feet of your bike. Your position on the bike is a key consideration. Some bikes have a more relaxed position and that allows you to ride more comfortably for hours on end. And some bikes have a very aggressive geometry, which makes it almost impossible to do a long sportive and to be comfortable at the same time. All of this combined with the bike fit ensures you choose the best bike that fits your body. I went into more details about a bike fit on one of my previous videos, which you can find by clicking on the link up here. The next consideration is weight. A lighter bike is a faster bike since you're carrying less weight around, but that comes with a high price tag as well. The lighter the bike is, the higher the price you pay. What you can try to achieve is a balance between a light weight and not so high price tag. The final consideration is the frame material. You have aluminium, carbon, steel, and titanium, where aluminium and carbon are the most common materials for bike frames. With all the already mentioned in mind, there is no right or wrong here, but you should buy the most comfortable bike you can find, and don't let the components put you off, because they can be changed and that bike can be transformed into your dream bike. The first bike on the list is a racing bike. These bikes are lightweight and designed for speed rather than comfort. They have a low front end and the frame is stiffer for super responsive handling. Usually comes with aero wheels and higher gearing for more speed. These bikes are usually at the very top when it comes to price for their lightweight components and stiffness of the frame. Another bike on our list is the sportive or endurance bikes. These bikes are built for comfort and they are a regular choice for sportives. These bikes have a lot of benefits of a racing bike, but the position is more upright, maximizing your comfort at the expense of aerodynamic efficiency. The frame is also less stiffer than a race bike to emphasize the comfort. The gears are usually lower, so you can cope with hills comfortably. In summary, this is a more comfortable racing bike and you should consider a sportive bike if speed, aerodynamic benefits and lightweight is not a priority and you are aiming for a more comfortable long ride. The next bike on our list is a TT bike or time trial. These bikes are designed for one single purpose, to go as fast as possible and cheat the wind in the process. This bike is filled with aerodynamic features to help the rider to cut through the air with the absolute minimum resistance, and this means less power is needed to move the bike forward. You can recognize one of these bikes anywhere, and the rider is in a lower position to maximize the speed and efficiency. The next bike on our list is the aero bike, which is my bike of choice, as you can see on my Ridley here. This bike has many features of a TT bike, but this puts these features into a more regular frame. These bikes tend to be heavier than an endurance bike, but the aerodynamic advantages make them worthwhile. Their frames are very stiff and they are built for you to cut through the air and not so much for comfort. They also have a low front end and the cables are hidden out, which means they run through the inside of the frame for aesthetics and for aerodynamic gains. The gears are also higher for more speed. My experiences with it, I absolutely love it, I really do. I've done so many rides with this bike and the only issue I have is that the frame is very stiff, which makes it not very comfortable when I'm doing long rides, but other than that, the bike is great. We're halfway through this video now, so let me know in the comment section below what bike you have and what are the positives and negatives of your bike. Another type of bike is the cyclocross bike, which takes riders to navigate mostly off-road and short courses with different terrains, riding surfaces and obstacles, which includes steep hills, logs, jumps and mud. Yes, a lot of mud. The frame of a cyclocross bike is stiff and lightweight as well, because you need to carry over obstacles and steep hills. This bike has a smaller range of gears for each course, disc brakes as well that provides better braking even in muddy or wet conditions, and it can also accommodate wider tires. This bike's geometry is fairly aggressive since they're only built for racing. The next bike in our list is the gravel bike, which has a lot of features from the cyclocross bike, but the geometry is similar to an endurance frame for more comfort. This bike is designed so you can tackle road and off-road smooth terrain comfortably. Most gravel bikes have disc brakes for when you need to ride off-road in wet conditions, and they can take wider tires as well. All of this flexibility this bike offers for riding road and off-road terrain comes in exchange for a reduction in speed, but this can be only marginal. The next bike on our list is the touring bike, which are built for comfort over longer distances and carrying heavy loads in the panniers. The loads can be camping stuff or items of clothes as well. The components on this bike are built to last and the gear is low, but you definitely appreciate it when the bike is loaded. The position on the bike is more upright to emphasize comfort, which is crucial when you are on long rides with a heavy load. The next bike on our list is a climb bike. If climbing is your thing, you need to get the lightest bike you can get, since you'll be fighting against gravity all the way up the hills. This bike is super lightweight, the frame is very responsive and stiff, since you want every single watt that you're producing to be transferred to your rear wheel. The gears on this bike can change significantly depending on your riding style and other rides you do. And the final bike on our list is the commuter bike. These are the real workhorses on the bike world, and they are built with comfort and durability in mind, so pretty much it's a bike that you want to jump on it and just go. This bike will take a bashing day after day on all weathers. Weight is not much of an issue, and they can also offer a more upright position, which helps you to see the traffic ahead. The gears on this bike can change as well, depending if your commute is hilly or flat. Most commuter bikes have disc brakes for better braking when riding in towns. Many people I know choose an endurance or gravel bike with low components for a commuter bike, so they can ride in all weather and it's cheaper to maintain as well. I'd like to add that no matter what bike you choose, you'll be able to tackle most rides, sportives and races out there with that one single bike that you have, but then you'll have to compromise. For example, if you buy an aero bike like my Ridley here, you can definitely complete a long sportive or try to smash a hill segment, but there will be a compromise in terms of comfort when doing long sportives or rides. Another example is that you compromise your speed for comfort when choosing an endurance bike. And that brings us to the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed and let me know in the comment section below what bike you have and what you use it for. Thanks for watching the video, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.